Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding to defeat or to contain Islamic State written by Stanley Johnny. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2. Plus this is very, very important for political science optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about how there is a dichotomy, how there is a difference between the approaches of the countries who are fighting against ISIS. Now, in order to understand this editorial, we need to understand two things. First of all, we need to understand the hierarchy of interests. And secondly, we need to understand the concept of nation state. How this concept has evolved and how this concept is on the wane. Now, as far as the concept of nation state is concerned, it evolved out of a Treaty of Westphalia signed in 17th century. Now, this treaty gave a shape to an intangible concept, the concept of state and a concept of nation. It was because of this very treaty we had been having these international relations. Had nation and state been not there, we would not been dealing with this international relations. So the primary reason of the international relations is the Treaty of Westphalia. With the coming in of this concept of sovereignty and integrity, this concept of nation got more entrenched, and it got more entrenched when World War I and World War II were formed. So till 1940s and 50s, we were just having the concept of nation and state. And before the concept of nation and state, we were just having monarchical setups. Those setups were not based on the defined territory. The territory of the monarchies were very vociferous, was very volatile, was very diluted, and the fights and the wars were fought on a continuous basis. From the war phase, we moved into a nation state. The number of wars, though subsided, but was still existent, and the wars were fought on the concept of nation. Earlier, the wars were fought on the concept of having access to large territory. So the main bone of contention before the concept of the nation and state was the land, was the resources, and very less was the basis of religion or of nation. But from 17th century onwards till the present century, the wars are being fought on the basis of nation and state. But of late, we are witnessing something new. We are witnessing the wars being fought more on the basis of ethnicity. The wars being more fought by the non-state actors. Now, these non-state actors, they don't believe in the concept of nation and state. They believe in establishing an idealistic state, a euphoric state, a state which, according to them, owes the legitimacy due to the religious texts. Now, the religious texts, according to these non-state actors, should be the guiding force of how the humans should be living. Now, this is the reason of the legitimization, this is the reason of the progress, this is the reason of the entrenchment, this is the reason of the strengthening of the ISIS. Had there been no legitimacy of the religion, the non-state actors would not have fought the war. So the wars prior to non-state actors were fought on the basis of nation, and prior to this nation-state concept, the wars were fought just for the resources. But in all these three things, three sort of wars, what is the common thing? The common thing is having access to power, having access to homogenize the things, having access to put forward your own agenda to the people who are not willing to accept your agenda. Now, we must also have an idea about the hierarchy of the interest. Now, when you look at this hierarchy of interest, at the lowest level of the hierarchy of the interest lies the self-interest. And above this, the second layer of the hierarchy of interest lies the interest of a community. Community means regional community on the basis of a territory, on the basis of land. Then another level of the hierarchy, we have another type of self-interest. Now this type of self-interest is based on religion. Is based on religion, is based on race, is based on color, is based on sex. Now these are the things which will be guiding your interest. At the topmost level of the hierarchy of the interest, we have the interest of the humanity, of fraternity, of brotherhood, of universalism, universalization. So this is how the hierarchy of the interests operate. Now presently, the nation state, though it should be guided by this humanity, fraternity, brotherhood and universalization, and this should be making up a point of collision between the capitalist and the socialist forces. But the capitalist and the socialist forces, they are not being guided by the topmost level of the hierarchy of interest. It is being guided more by the religion, more by the race, more by the color, more by the sex, and more by the economy. And because of this, we are having capitalist and socialist setups in the world, two polar apart setups. And because of this, we are having the divisions like Shias and the Sunnis. And because of this, we are having the divisions like the Hindus, the Muslims. So the humanity should be guided by fraternity, by the concept of esprit de corps, by the concept of brotherhood, and by the concept of universalization. Because it is the universalism that will help the humanity to survive. If we will be guided by the religion, the race, the color, the sex, and the economy, we will be fighting against each other. Now, this level of this hierarchical level gives rise to the concept of identity. And when the concept of identity comes into being, we begin to feel as if we all are antagonistic. And this editorial, to defeat or to contain Islamic State, Stanley Johnny, he has put forward how the world is not having a kind of a consensus to fight against this huge evil force of ISIS. If we want to tackle with this huge evil force of ISIS, we should be guided by the topmost level of the hierarchy. We should be making this aspect more potent. And this aspect, it negates the concept of nation. It negates the concept of non-state actors. It negates the concept of other state actors. It negates the concept of religion, everything. Humanity and brotherhood is the most important thing as per the topmost layer of the hierarchy of interests. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIAS Mentors. You can contact me at 84594-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes and IAS Civil Services Preparation. And you can also avail the information of the class that we are offering from our websites eiasmentors.com and preniki.com. And in case you like this video, do click on the like button, do share and comment on this video. And you can also install our application. The name of the application is Preniki. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And do like, if in case you like this video, please do click on the like button, do share and comment on this video. And do participate in the answer writing program. And you can also join the test series program that we have launched tomorrow. Is the test on polity prelims and modern history prelims. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.